Kneel down or stand up as we welcome the Lord.
Sacraments.
as we look to the Lord Jesus this evening. I want to encourage us to really give ourselves to the Lord. The Lord is here. The Lord is among us. And as we pray, I just sense the Lord is so happy to be with us. The Lord is so happy to be with us. This evening, brothers and sisters, I want to encourage us individually and as a community to really give our all to Him. If you want to take a more comfortable posture, feel free to do so. Just request you to fill in as many empty places as possible so that our brothers and sisters who come later can come in and sit peacefully. As the music plays for the next few moments, and as we allow the Lord to draw us into adoration, adoration is never an act of will of man. Adoration is never an act where you and I even possibly voluntarily bring ourselves to God. No, it is the Lord who draws us to Him. It was always the Lord. It has always been the Lord. And sometimes, brothers and sisters, this realization makes all the difference. The realization that it was not I. It was not because I left work early. It was not because I left home early. But it was the Lord who engineered every circumstance in this day to bring me into His presence. It was the Lord who removed every possible obstacle and is still removing obstacles so that we can worship in His presence, so that we can experience His love this evening. Let us allow this knowledge and this experience to flow through us as we surrender our lives to God tonight. If there is any unconfessed sin in our lives, I want to encourage us to confess our sins to God. The Word of God says in Isaiah chapter 43, He says, I, even I am He that blots out your transgressions for my own name's sake and remembers your sin no more. And remembers your sin no more. This evening, brothers and sisters, we are faced with a God right in front of us who remembers our sins no more. We'll ask the Lord to take us to the river. To the river of His grace. To the river of His mercy, so that we're engulfed in it. So that nothing remains tonight. Tonight should be a night about Jesus. This evening should be an evening about Jesus. So that we leave ourselves just as we are in His presence. And we take only Him with us tonight. Surrender. For all the times that we haven't surrendered to the Lord, how beautiful it is to just be able to let go in His presence. Whatever it is, work, family, finances, responsibilities, worries, anxieties, children, spouse, parents, just let it go into His presence. Let it go. Say, Lord, I give it to You tonight. I give it to You tonight. I hold nothing back for myself. I give it to You tonight, Lord. I give it to You tonight. I don't want anything, Lord. I don't want to take control of my life. I want to give You control. I don't ever want to look at my life as my own. I want to look at my life as Yours and Yours alone. Just continue to give it to the Lord Jesus right now. Just continue to give it to the Lord Jesus right now. Just give it to the Lord Jesus right now. Just one thing the Lord wants to make us aware of, and that is the reality of His presence. Because when someone is real to you, then you're able to give. And although many times we tell the Lord that we love Him, the reality of His presence is a little lacking. Thomas had a problem with that. And so in the gospel, when Jesus appeared to the disciples and he wasn't there, he was hurt and scared, and at the same time he said, no, I will not believe. I will not believe based on hearsay. Unless I put my finger into his hands and put my hand into his side where it was hurt with the spear, I can't believe. And the Lord was okay with that. The Lord was really okay with that. So the Lord appears the next week when Thomas is with the disciples, with the apostles. And Jesus says, Thomas, put your finger into the hole of my hand where the nails were, and put your hand into my side and believe. Believe. Response. Thomas could have followed through, you know. Thomas could have followed through. He could have done it. But to see Jesus was enough for Thomas. It was enough. Thomas would never need another touch his entire life. Thomas would never need another perspective his entire life. Thomas had Jesus. He had seen the Lord. His response to Jesus' invitation was, my Lord and my God. My Lord and my God. Brothers and sisters, Jesus stands before us tonight. He's asking for your response, but he's also saying, come. If you don't believe, come. Put your hand. Put your finger into my hand. Put your hand into my side. But believe. Tonight, that's what the Lord is saying. Believe. The Lord is calling each and every one of us tonight. The Lord is saying, believe. The Lord is saying, I can't let you go without believing. Because you're my son. You're my daughter. I can't let you go. Sisters, I want to encourage us as a community and individually to put our belief in the Lord Jesus tonight. As we raise our hands to the Lord, put your belief in the Lord. Put your belief in the Lord. Tell the Lord, Lord, sometimes I've faltered, Lord, but today, like Thomas, I say, my Lord and my God, I put my entire belief in you, Lord. My entire trust in you. I put my entire life and everything that I have and everything that I want, I put it in you, Lord Jesus. I put it in you tonight. eagle.
I'll rise up like an eagle, and I will soar with you. Your spirit leads me on by the power of your love.
Tell him, Lord, unveil my eyes.
Lord, unveil my eyes. Let me see you.
Brothers and sisters, I want to encourage us today to have faith in God, to put our faith in God. No matter how many times we feel that our prayers haven't been answered, there have been an equal, if not more, number of times that God has answered us. And so this evening, as we surrender our lives to God, thank you. God our one desire. We make God our one desire. In the Blessed Sacrament, we find all that we need tonight. And so I want to encourage you, brothers and sisters, don't get tired tonight. As we worship the Lord Jesus, don't get tired. Just continue to look at the Lord Jesus. Continue to focus on the Lord Jesus. Do not be afraid, God is with you. Do not be dismayed, God is by your side. It's what the Word of God says. It's what the Word of God says. And so we're going to continue to focus on the Lord. Continue to surrender our lives to God. Don't be afraid, brothers and sisters. Don't be afraid. Don't be afraid today. The Lord is here in our midst, the mighty one of Israel. There is no need to be afraid. Just continue to give your life to God. Don't worry about your sicknesses. Don't worry about your problems. Don't worry about your worries. Don't worry about anything today. God is in control. God is in the house. And when God is in control and God is in the house, then nothing is required. Only Jesus and nothing else. Only Jesus and no one else. His presence is enough. His presence is all that we need tonight.
Yeah.
we focus on the Lord this evening, brothers and sisters. Just sense the Lord speaking to 18 people here. The Lord is saying, do not be afraid, I am with you. The Lord is speaking to 2 people here with a neck problem. You've had a neck problem for over 8 years. The Lord is healing you right now. The Lord is speaking to 15 people here. You have a problem with going to the bathroom often in the night. The Lord is healing you right now. There are 3 people here. You have a problem with your knee. The Lord is healing you right now. Right now, the Lord is healing you. The Lord is speaking to 5 people here. The Lord is saying, your throat gets dry very quickly. And even if you drink water, the Lord is saying, you're not able to. You just feel dry all the time. You feel choked all the time. The Lord is saying, He's healing you right now. The Lord is speaking to 3 people here with an eye problem. Because of that, you have headaches and you have migraine. The Lord is healing you right now. The Lord is speaking to 3 mothers here. The Lord is saying, young mothers. The Lord is saying, 2 are here, 1 is not, 1 is watching. The Lord is saying, trust me, I'm healing you. The Lord is saying, there are some sicknesses that have come after you gave birth. The Lord is healing you right now, including body pain, including back pain. The Lord is healing you right now. The Lord is speaking to 5 fathers here. The Lord is saying, you have an incessant problem with lust. The Lord is healing you right now. The Lord is healing you right now. I want to encourage the worship team to speak as the Lord gives utterance.
The Lord is showing a vision of an archer, many archers releasing flames of arrow.
I sense the Lord speaking to many of us here. The Lord is saying, although a lot of evil will come against you, the Lord is saying, I will be your protector. I will be your guide. The Lord is saying, do not be afraid.
The Lord is showing a vision of a torch with a white light beaming from which it divides into 3 and then multiplies.
I sense the Lord speaking to us today. The Lord is saying, grace comes from the Father, Son, and Spirit and multiplies in this room.
Is showing a vision of an empty wine glass.
I sense the Lord speaking to 18 people here. The Lord is saying, your glass is empty because you do not pray. The Lord is saying, I want to fill your glass. I want to fill you with my grace.
The Lord is showing a vision of a man on a scooter and it breaks down and he's trying to fix it up.
I sense the Lord speaking to a person here. The Lord is saying, you have no other vehicle for transportation and the bike that you use keeps giving you problems. The Lord is saying, pray and I will supernaturally make sure that this problem goes away for you.
The Lord is showing an upside down mirror.
I sense the Lord speaking to 5 women here. The Lord is saying that you don't like the way you look. And when you look in the mirror, everything seems to be wrong about you. The Lord is telling you today, my child, I love you. I have called you by name. You are mine. The Lord is saying, your image depends on what I say it is. And I call you my child. I call you perfect, says the Lord. You are not to look in the mirror and judge yourself. You are to look in the mirror and be reminded of me, who is your creator.
The Lord is showing a huge eye of a crocodile which is only half open.
I sense the Lord speaking to a few people here. The Lord is saying, in your families you have gossiped, and because of your gossip you have destroyed either your family or somebody else's family. Today the Lord is saying, repent for your sin. The Lord is saying, I want to change you. I want to make you into my own, says the Lord.
The Lord is showing in the air around us a huge boa constrictor. He's extracting it from the room.
I sense the Lord saying, there are many great sins in this place that God is removing right now. The Lord is encouraging us to just surrender. This is a time of grace in the presence of the Blessed Sacrament. It's a time of grace, a time of healing, a time for removal of any sin that is deeply entrenched in our lives and in our hearts.
The Lord is showing a vision of a long table with a white cloth, many big glasses empty laid on that table.
I sense the Lord inviting us to His table to partake of His grace.
Lord showing a vision of a pot, it's multicolored.
I sense the Lord saying, do not be afraid. I sense the Lord saying, trust in me. The Lord is looking at us. and saying, I, the Lord, will bring out all your talents. I, the Lord, will ensure that your life has color.
The Lord is showing a wooden plow, and it is fixed onto two bulls, and it is plowing land.
I sense the Lord speaking to many of us here. The Lord is saying, go into my land. And look for the harvest. I, the Lord, will lead you not only to till the land, but to reap the harvest.
I sense the Lord washing the feet of people row after row.
The Lord is cleansing many of us here, although we don't want to be cleansed. The Lord is healing many of us here.
The Lord is showing a vision of a signboard with many signs on it.
I sense the Lord speaking to us. The Lord is saying, read the signs that I have kept for you through my word, through the Eucharist, and you will never fall into danger.
The Lord is showing a tiny aeroplane.
I sense the Lord speaking to a few people here. The Lord is saying, you will travel abroad through work.
The Lord is showing a black telephone which was there in the 1980s with a dial.
I sense the Lord speaking to six people here. The Lord is saying, you're stuck in your past with your past actions. The Lord is saying, repent for it and come out of it quickly, for I'm giving you the grace right now, says the Lord.
The Lord is showing a small plantation with completely burnt trees.
I sense the Lord speaking to five people here. The Lord is saying that whatever you've planted has not succeeded. The Lord is saying, today I'm changing that. Whatever you touch will begin to become successful. The Lord is saying, put my word to practice in your life and you will find this happening immediately.
The Lord is showing a vision of a garden filled with roses, red roses.
The Lord is leading many of us into deep prayer. The Lord is saying, in my garden, I want to tend to you because you are precious to me, says the Lord.
The Lord is showing a little feast, and the lamps which are hanging are made of candles.
I sense the Lord continuing to invite us into his presence. The Lord is saying, drink of my presence, eat of my presence. The Lord is saying, there is more and more for me to give you. Open your heart to me, says the Lord.
The Lord is showing a beautiful silver tree, a very royal tree, which is empty.
I sense the Lord speaking to some of us here, especially women. The Lord is saying, take shelter under my wings. Take shelter under the shade that I have given you. Do not be afraid, says the Lord.
The Lord is showing a vision of him pouring olive oil into a glass.
The Lord is speaking to some of us here. The Lord is filling us with his Holy Spirit. I want to encourage all of us right now to continue to surrender to the Lord, to continue to focus on the Lord. The Lord has a message for each and every one of us, not only through prophecy, but the Lord wants to speak directly. The Lord is saying, there are some of us here who are getting visions. There are some of us here who are getting scriptures. It is the Lord. Do not be afraid. It is the Lord speaking to you right now. And so surrender to the Lord right now as we give our lives to Jesus again and again, as we focus on the Lord again and again. Brothers and sisters, I want to encourage you. Remember the gifts, this prophecy, these are gifts of God. These are gifts of God, but it is not God. These are only gifts from the giver. The giver is waiting for you and me right now. It is good for us to accept the gifts, but it is even better to receive the giver, to receive Jesus tonight.
The atmosphere is changing now
here in this place.
For the Spirit of the Lord is here. The evidence is all around. For the Spirit of the Lord is here. The atmosphere is changing now. praise, for the Spirit of the Lord is here. The evidence is all around
in this place,
for the Spirit of the Lord is here. Overflow in this place, fill our hearts with your love, and your love surrounds us.
On the Lord Jesus. Look at the Lord Jesus. Tell the Lord, Lord, change my heart. Change my soul. Change everything within me. Do not leave me, Lord, to my own decisions. Do not leave me, Lord. Change the atmosphere in my heart, in my work, in my household, in my mind. Change everything, Lord. I want to become like you. No more do I want to become like I was in the past, Lord Jesus. No more, Lord Jesus. Overflow in this place.
Overflow in this place. Fill our hearts with your love. Your love surrounds us. Overflow.
the Lord says, be still and know that I am your God. Let us be still. Let us be seated. All of us are before your God. God who created the seen and the unseen, the whole world and everything in that. The past, present and the future is created by the one who is before us in the Blessed Sacrament. The one who is the Blessed Sacrament told us in Matthew 18:14, likewise, my Father does not like any one of these little ones be perished. My Father likes everyone to be saved. He doesn't want anyone to be perished. He loves us so much that he sent his only begotten Son as a ransom for our sins. We have been caught in our sins, in our temptations, in our weaknesses, in our sicknesses, in our difficulties, in our failures, all these brought by the great sin that was committed by our forefathers. Now, no one is able to get out of his sin by himself. Therefore, Father sent his only begotten Son as a ransom for our sins. Jesus came and purchased us from the slavery of Satan by shedding his precious blood. We are the purchased one. We are the saved one. And the price was to be paid for us purchasing was the precious blood of Jesus. That's why the representative of Jesus, the present representative of Jesus, Pope Francis says in his Christus Vivit, you are priceless before the Lord because the priceless blood is shed for your salvation. My dear friends, brothers and sisters, we are bought, we are purchased by the precious blood of Jesus who is before us. God the Father wants all of us to be saved. So he sent his Son. He came, he loved us so much that he gave up his own life. He shed his blood, the last drop of his blood was shed for your salvation, for my salvation. We are the saved people. So let us be happy, let us rejoice, let us be always praising the Lord. In the church now, we are leading a life of adoration and worship where we are told that apostles imbibed by the Spirit of the Lord, knowing that we are the purchased one, knowing that we are filled with the Holy Spirit, went out preaching the gospel of the Lord, went out paying witness to the great love of Jesus. The great saint, great apostle Thomas came to India. We celebrated his feast day yesterday. He came to India. He just shared what he experienced. He saw Jesus while he was living. He saw Jesus while he was working miracles. He saw Jesus being persecuted by the Jews. He seen Jesus being beaten up by the soldiers. He saw Jesus being crucified. He saw Jesus hung on the cross. He saw Jesus being buried. Of course, he saw Jesus resurrected. He saw his wounds on the hands, on the side, and Jesus, he said, my Lord, my God. He said, my Lord, my God, that has transformed his life. He ran around the world preaching and paying witness to the great love of Jesus. Saint Francis Xavier came here. He was filled with experience of Jesus. The early martyrs were filled with experience of Jesus. the love that was given to us by Jesus. Filled by the love of Jesus, they were even ready to lay down their own life. St. Paul was one of them. He said, now I am living. The life that I am living is for the one Jesus who loved me, and for the Jesus who laid down his life for me. When we are completely convinced that Jesus has laid down his life for me, he loved me and he saves me, we cannot just sit down and take rest. We have to go running around, praising and preaching and sharing the love that Jesus has given us. We are here before the Lord, experiencing his protection, his sweet words, his saving presence, and his healing. We experience that. It's not enough that experience his love and his saving experience. We have to get out of this hall after the prayers, share with our friends, our relatives, and even strangers what the Lord has done for us. Jesus is present here. Jesus is present here, right here, not only here, everywhere we go. He accompanies us, and we have to pay witness to Jesus. We Christians who are baptized in his life, we are dead to sin, and we are living in his spirit. We have to pay witness to him. We have to share the love that is given to us, and that is possible by the Holy Spirit. The apostles who were afraid, hid themselves in the room, were filled with the Holy Spirit on the Pentecost day, and they became great fire. They became fire and shared Jesus everywhere they went. Similarly, we have to be filled with the Holy Spirit. We are filled with the Holy Spirit and go out and share the great salvation that is wrought to us by Lord Jesus Christ. God the Father wants us to be saved. Not only us, the whole world wants to be saved. Jesus gave his life for us, for our salvation, and the Spirit is there to lead each one of us. Therefore, let us bow before the Holy Blessed Trinity for the great mystery of salvation that is wrought through the death, resurrection of Jesus. We are witnesses. We are witnesses, and we are strengthened by the Holy Spirit. Let us ask Lord to be strengthened by the Spirit and go out as fire, and that fire of love, fire of holiness, and fire of witness being paid to the Lord. Amen.
Spirit, purify my heart.
As we continue to focus on the Lord Jesus, along with Bishop Lawrence, a few of the Bread of Life elders will stand to pray with you. The ushers will lead you in two lines, but as you come and pray, it's not the duration of the prayer, it's not who's laying hands over you. It is the Lord anointing you right now. It is the Lord anointing you right now. I want to request the elders to come in front, stand along with Bishop Lawrence as we pray for people. Brother Mark, Mavis, Brother Cherian, Brother Simon, you can stand in one line before the Blessed Sacrament. Brother Richard, Selvi, worship the Lord. As we worship the Lord, the people will come. Srinivas. Father Basil. Sisters, pray over you, my dear brothers and sisters. Focus on the Lord Jesus and no one else. You can start coming two by two. The atmosphere is changing now here in this place.
For the Spirit of the Lord is here.
Thank you.
sisters, we're going to ask God for a miracle. Whatever it is, the Lord is going to give it to us today. Through the laying on of hands, through the power of the Holy Spirit, the power of the Eucharist in this place, the Lord is going to move. Have no doubt, have no fear. For the one standing on the balcony or sitting on the balcony, once all the people here finish, the volunteers will lead you. Either somebody will come up to pray for you or you can come down. Just focus on the Lord tonight. This evening is about Jesus. This evening is about Jesus. This evening is about no one else but Jesus.
Hallelujah.
belongs to the Lord. The weapon that's fashioned against us will stand. The battle belongs to the Lord. In heavenly armor we enter the land. The battle belongs to the Lord. The weapon that's fashioned against us will stand. The battle belongs to the Lord. We sing glory.
Brothers and sisters, let's claim Isaiah 54. Which says, no weapon shall prosper, and you shall refute every tongue that rises against you in judgment. Today, let us rebuke every weapon that's fashioned against us in the spiritual realm, as it is written in the Word of God. Let us rebuke every weapon fashioned against us in the name of Jesus. Every weapon of the enemy right now, in the name of Jesus, we rebuke it right now. Every external and internal disturbance right now, in the name of Jesus, we rebuke you. Sisters, let's worship the Lord today. Let's not give up on Jesus. Let's forget about the power. Let's worship Him with our hands, with our mouths. In the early days, the church did not have any sound. They don't have any of these facilities. They just had themselves in the Lord. And they were grateful. They were joyful. They were not gripping. They were not grumbling. We're just thankful in the presence of God. We're just grateful to be in the presence of Jesus.
Who is like you, blind and the lamb, seated on the throne? Mountains bow down, and every ocean roars to the Lord of all.
Who is like him?
Who is like him? To the Lord of hosts. Praise the Lord high, from the rising of the sun to the end of every day. Praise the Lord high, all the nations of the earth, all the angels and the saints sing praise.
Come on.
seated on the throne. Mountains bow down and every ocean rose to the Lord of hosts. Who's like Him, the Lion and the Lamb, seated on the throne. Mountains bow down and every ocean rose to the Lord of hosts. Praise and adore from the rising of the sun to the end of every day. Praise and adore all the nations of the earth, all the angels and the saints.
Awesome and power of God. Thank you, Jesus, for
praise you, Lord. Hallelujah. Restore, Lord. Renew, Lord. Shine, Lord. You shine. Shine forth, Lord. Shine to all the darkness in this place, Lord.
We've been looking for methods all our lives. We've been looking for techniques. We've been looking for ways for breakthroughs in our lives. But the Bible teaches us that we are Israel. Israel had only one way of seeking God, one way of following God, one way of awakening their God. And that was a way of praise, a lifestyle of praise. As we continue to praise and worship our God, let's pray even for our brothers and sisters as they go and the Lord lays His hands on them today. Let us pray that the Lord touches them. That they receive Christ, they receive Jesus. Let's pray for their faith right now to increase. Let's destroy the works of the enemy as we praise and worship our God. Praise is rising.
Eyes are turning to you. We turn to you. Hope is stirring, hearts are yearning for you. We long for you.
Come on, praise is rising.
Rising,
let your praise rise.
Eyes are turning to you. We turn to you.
Hope is stirring.
Hope is stirring. Hearts are yearning for you. We long for you. When we see you, we find strength to face the day. In your presence, all our fears are washed away. Washed away. Hosanna, Hosanna. You are the God who saves us. Worthy of all our praises. Lord
sound. Worship the Lord, brothers and sisters. Thank you.
satisfy. You are provision for the journey of our life.
Stop it now and say, Lord, I forgive completely, because we receive our forgiveness from the cross. Because on the cross, Jesus said, Father, forgive them, for they know not what they do. And from there, He gave us, He offered forgiveness when we were in the depth of our sin. Now that we have received this forgiveness, this cleansing, this blood from His presence, it is only right for us to give it to our neighbor, no matter what the neighbor has done for us, because we crucified Jesus and He forgave us. I don't think our neighbors have crucified us like that. Your neighbor could be your spouse, your neighbor could be your children, your parents, your neighbor could be your boss, your neighbor could be people you know, your neighbor could be people in the past, your neighbor could be people you work with. It doesn't matter. It doesn't matter. All that matters tonight is Jesus. All that matters tonight is Jesus. Amen. Amen. I can't hear you. Amen. Father, bring the blessed sacrament. Forgive each and everyone as we trust in the Lord, as we proclaim Him as Lord and Master, as we proclaim Him as my Lord and my God, as Thomas did, as St. Thomas did. We lift up the name of Jesus tonight like we've never done before. Like we've never done before. You are the first. You are the first.
You are the sweet.
You are the
Lord.
Singing this softly to the Lord.
You are everything.
Tell him you are everything.
You are everything. Jesus, 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 you are everything.
You are.
You are.
I just look at the Lord Jesus, experience his love. Brothers and sisters, make a decision to take God home tonight. Make a decision to take the Lord Jesus home. Don't leave this place without the Lord Jesus. Don't leave this place without his presence. Don't leave this place without his love. Don't leave this place without his word. Don't leave this place without his healing and deliverance. But most of all, don't leave this place without him and him alone. Without Jesus and Jesus alone. Let the Lord Jesus be your guide and your light.
Just one thing that matters. Dear
It's all been said and done. All my treasures will mean nothing. Only what I've done for love's reward will stand the test. So
gives us the final blessing.
The Lord be with you. May Almighty God bless you, the Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit come down on you and remain with you now and forever.
Amen.
Let's just continue to be in the presence of the Lord, brothers and sisters. Adoring the Lord, communing with Jesus. Can we just raise our hands? The Lord wants to complete the healing that He started. The Lord wants to complete the healing that He started. Just a few moments longer. The word of God says, I am the Lord that healeth thee. I am the Lord that healeth thee. I send my word and I heal your disease. Can we just raise our right hands to the Lord as we come to an end of this time? Just receive the scripture of healing. This is for you, for me, and for our families. It's not to be kept to ourselves. It is for you and for me and for our friends. It's not to be kept to ourselves. It's for you and for me and for our enemies. It is not to be kept to ourselves. Repeat after me. I am the Lord.
I am the Lord.
that healeth thee.
That healeth thee.
I am the Lord.
I am the Lord.
That healeth thee.
That healeth thee.
I am the Lord.
I am the Lord.
That healeth thee.
That healeth thee.
I send my word.
I send my word.
And I heal your disease.
And I heal your disease.
I send my word.
I send my word.
And I heal your disease.
And I heal your disease.
I send my word.
I send my word.
And I heal your disease.
And I heal your disease.
Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you.
Praise you, Lord. Hallelujah. 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 Blessed be the name of the Lord. Hallelujah. 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 Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord.
The Lord is healing somebody's lungs right now.
Healing three people of stomach pain, three women. I encourage the worship team to speak as the Lord gives scriptures or messages of healing.
The Lord is healing someone's right wrist.
The Lord is healing somebody of an addiction to smoking, especially electronic cigarettes.
The Lord is touching someone with cancer of the bone.
The Lord is healing someone's ball and socket in the shoulder, right shoulder.
The Lord is healing a mother's womb here.
The Lord is delivering a brother from smoking.
The Lord is healing someone of brain tumor.
Stomach, the Lord is healing it. There's a sister here with suicidal tendencies. The Lord is delivering you.
The Lord is healing a huge swelling in somebody's body.
There is someone with a pain in the heel, the right foot heel. The Lord is healing you.
Lord is healing three people with PCOD. Lord is moving right now. You can sense it, receive it.
Thank you, Jesus. Lord is healing the lower back of five people here.
The Lord is healing fibroids in the uterus.
The Lord is healing 11 people from migraine.
Thank you, Jesus.
Somebody with ovarian cysts is being touched by the Lord.
Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord.
The Lord is healing someone from an ankle pain.
The Lord is healing people with addictions.
Can we raise our hands to the Lord? Lord, I need you.
Oh, I need you.
Every hour. Amen. Amen. Amen.